open here. Hey, Vixen. Hey, Sheila. Did I say that right? I don't know what that is. Oh, good. Because there's an I thrown in there. So I thought I was saying it wrong. Oh, you know what, Vixen? I haven't been on live every day, so you're not missing anything. But YouTube, I've been posting a lot of the lives that I haven't been able to upload. So go to YouTube. You can catch some of my lives. But I haven't been on every day. I'm not doing them every day now. Hey, Sally. It's not late, Sally. It's Friday. I know. So usually I am in bed by now, though, honestly. But the past couple nights, I've been just like laying in bed, just like staring at the ceiling. So I'm like, I might as well do a live, right? Aw. Thanks, Vanessa. Happy Friday. This is a horrible angle for my phone. It's as high as this thing goes. But it'll do. Aw, I love that, Vixen. Yeah, so it's all about, it's really the main thing to all the practices that I talk about are bringing you back to this present moment. It's helping you live in this present moment. Understanding that all your power is in this present moment. It's not in techniques. It's not in doing things, taking action or any of that. It's literally in this present moment with the life you're living now. So that's what that's what non-reaction is. That's what non-reaction is going to help you get back to this present moment. And the more you can practice being in this present moment, you get clarity on how this reality really truly works, right? And understanding it, that everything's just a mirror reflecting back to you your limiting belief systems, right? Because that's all this is. This experience is you having your own experience with your belief systems. It's only your energy. What state are you from? Yeah, it's Philly accent. It's a Philly accent. No, Jen, I'm not doing them as often. So my lives, for me, I'm like at a place where I feel like I'm moving out of my doing them every day. So for me, it's more of like when I do them, I'm just so exhausted. And so I'm not doing them every day, but I will always be doing lives, guys, just not every single day now. So check out my YouTube, though, because YouTube, I post all of my lives. So you can catch all my lives, you know, pre-recorded, like on there. I put them on YouTube, so you can always catch them there. And if you guys ever have questions or anything, you guys know how this works and how I explain it. You really want to get out of the question mode. You want to get out of that, right? You really want to be in this present moment and just do the practices of calmness, quietness, and relaxing your body. You really want to do those types of practices. That's practicing non-reaction. But if you ever have a question or you just need some reassurance, you can always ask me on here and I will make you your own personal video. I feel like my kids must have spilled something because I'm feeling sticky. I'm feeling sticky on this floor. It's driving me crazy. Hi, Vince. Yeah, JMC. So it's like non-reaction is, and by staying calm and quiet in the moments that you don't feel good, that's what's leading you to feeling good on a more regular basis, right? But at first, we're very reactive. We're reactive, and that's what repeats patterns. That's what repeats cycles. That's what repeats stories that don't serve you. So by practicing non-reaction, you start to automatically align with things that are more, that are meant for you. You know, things that are more in alignment with you. You start to feel good. It's a natural, it's the byproduct of practicing non-reaction, right? It's very simple what you're doing. It's really very simple. It's just, you got to keep doing it. You got to keep practicing it. You're falling into trust and knowing that you're always taken care of and you're always moving towards best and better in each moment. And the more you do the practice, the more you see it in your reality. But you're never doing anything to manifest. And I mean that, guys. I really mean that. You really want to get, that's another program. When you're doing things to manifest, affirmations, visualization techniques, scripting and all those things, that's just another program, right? So you really want to just bring your attention and focus back to this moment. Whatever you want is done. The answer is always yes as soon as you ask, right? And you're living your everyday normal life. That's it. So when you start to think about your manifestation, I always tell people, like, for the most part, you're probably thinking good about it. But when you start to feel off, you want to say, all right, let me bring my attention back to this moment. What can I do now to feel good? And start making that your practice in each moment to get yourself back into this now move moment. Hi, Miguel. Hi, Linda. Well, you don't want, that's the thing. Well said. Remember, you don't want to be in that needy energy, right? You want to be more in that feeling whole on your own. That's what these practices do. You start to feel whole and complete on your own, and you're happy with who you are and where you are at in your life. And that's what will bring in a healthy relationship, right? And that's also what's bringing in your manifestations in the best way possible as well. Like I said, your life's going to get better. Your life's going to get better. Things are going to manifest that are more in alignment with you. But some of your bigger manifestations, like some people are manifesting, like, you know, financial freedom's a big one, right? Breaking through your money beliefs, relationships, your body, right? Things like that. But you have to first do these practices and be okay with where you're at for things to really come in the best way possible for you. But like I said, things are unfolding. Things are happening, right? But you're not supposed to get involved in that part. Hi, Catherine. Hi, Dee Dee. Oh, I love it, Vince. I love it. I'm telling you, this is it. This is it. This is what everybody's seeking. You want to, that's why, like I said, everything evolved for me. There was no action involved, guys. There was no action involved when it came to my TikToks, when it came to my ebooks, when it came to my audio that I made for you guys, which totally makes sense, right? It's everything I talk about. Now, before, when I wrote other books in the past, there was action involved. There was so much action involved because I didn't get it yet. I was still practicing, right? So that's why I said it takes practice to really get it. But I believe that the stuff that I have out now today, my ebooks, Feel Good, Stay Calm, and Release Resistance, my recent one, How to Stay in Flow, and my audio are the best resources to be in the present moment, right? To help you practice non-reaction. So people are getting this quicker because of those resources, right? But it took me time to develop those resources, right? And that's why people are telling me that they're getting it and it's working. But so the audio is good because it helps you in those moments you don't feel good. You can pop that right on and you start to relax your body. Because when anything that shows up that doesn't feel good, it's just an opposition of what you want. That's all. It's that simple. Anytime you don't feel good, it's just you're in opposition of what you want. Manifestations, everything. That's all it is. Plain and simple. So in those moments, you just have to get calm and quiet and relax your body. That's it. And allow it to pass. But it doesn't feel good, guys. And that's where people start to react and repeat. So that's why I created the audios to help you guys, because that's what helped me. That's what helped me. This floor is driving me crazy. It's sticky. Somebody spilled something and didn't tell me. Yes, Nene, usually I'm in bed by now, but I was saying, like, I'm not even sleeping. I'm just, like, laying there for, like, 2 hours, and I don't fall asleep till, like, 1 a.m. So I was like, you know what? Tonight, it's Friday night. I'm hopping on a live for a little bit. Maybe, because you know what? Lives tire me out. That's why I don't do them as much, because I actually get tired from them. So I figure if I do this now, maybe I'll be tired. Hi, Bella. Hi, Mindful. Well, Mindful, that's the thing. You don't want something outside. You can't want something outside of you to fill that, right? You need to fill that on your own. So this is where you're going to do the practices. This is where you're going to feel better on your own, right? It's only you and your energy. Mindful, you have to do these practices for a little bit to really understand how this reality works. It's you and your energy. It's you having your own experience with your own belief systems, guys. It's literally only you and your energy. So that's a story you're telling yourself, Mindful. That's a limiting belief that you're experiencing that in your reality, and you'll continue to experience it. It's only you and your energy. Nobody's trying to hurt you in your reality. Nobody's trying to belittle you in your reality. Nobody's jealous of you in your reality. Nobody wants bad for you in your reality. No one's trying to hurt you in your reality. It's a belief system within you. Like I said, anything at all that doesn't feel good, guys, is a limiting belief. It's your limiting belief. It's nobody else's. So we do the practice. We don't speak about it. We don't tell anyone about it. We go within and we relax and we stay quiet and we soften our bodies, because that's a limiting belief is hard and dense. You do the opposite, soften, relax, and you just allow it to pass, Mindful. That's it. That's all that is. But that's it. Then you focus on this moment, Mindful. You focus on what you're living now in your everyday life. You're making the best of where you're at now, guys. That's all you're doing. I'm making the best of my life now, and those moments I don't feel good, I get calm, I get quiet, and I relax my body. And that's all you're ever doing. Hey, Mike. Yeah, but Mindful, you're not wrong, guys. When you ask questions, I get it. I want to get you out of the question mood, right? But sometimes you just need to keep reminding yourself, oh, wait, no, like, I just have to relax. Oh, no, that's again why I tell you, go check out, either watch the lives or scroll through my videos. Put some in your favorites to remind you. You don't have to do anything. You just have to relax your body. Hey, Nathan. Of course, user. That's so cool, Nene. Keeping calm is just about the best thing you can find. It is. And you can't relax enough. And that's what a lot of people are like, is there ever a point where you're, no, you can never relax too much. When you're relaxing, you're releasing limiting beliefs. You're releasing fear-based belief systems. Trust me, there's going to come a time where your life's going to start to pick up and you're going to be like, oh gosh, remember that time I just sat around and I relaxed? I missed that time. So no, you cannot relax enough. Trust me. We have a lot. I don't like to say we have a lot of limiting beliefs, but you know, we all know where we are with these things. There you go, Camilla. So yeah, it's more so about, and that's another thing I always say, like, it's more so about experiences, right? Don't make it about, like, these things. Make it more about the experience, right? That's all this reality is. It's just you having experiences, right? But it all comes down to you feeling whole and complete on your own and being happy in this moment. Now you know more in this moment. You know you're unlimited in this moment. You know you can be, do, and have anything you want in this moment, right? You know everything is done in the best way possible in this moment. And that's all you need to know. That's it. You bring your attention back to this moment and feel good now. Well, yeah, because, well, April, it's just understanding that you're unlimited, right? You're unlimited. So I always say start with that word. You're unlimited. You can't even comprehend how unlimited you actually are, right? So, yes, every reality exists in this moment. Anything you could possibly think of, April, exists in this moment. Literally, anything you could possibly want. I always say it like this as well, like, not only what you want, not only what your desire, like your desire of what you want is done in this moment, but the best version of it, right? Because there's so many versions of it that can come into your reality, that can come into your experience. So there's a best version of it, right? That's how unlimited you are. But the more you bring your attention back to this moment, April, not really make it about this experience, this manifestation, and bring it back to this moment, that's where all your power is, right? So you want to bring your attention and focus back to this moment, not thinking too much about, like, you actually want to get out of that, believe it or not, guys. You want to get out of the trying to figure out how this works, how this reality works, how is there every possibility, because it's so overwhelming, and you'll never be able to comprehend it. You won't. You're not really supposed to. Like, this is just, you're here to have a fun, amazing experience. Now we know that we are unlimited. We can be doing anything we want. This is just a fun experience. And that's enough. That's enough. Don't dive too deep into these concepts. Don't get too much into, like, this. I mean, if you like this, I don't tell people you can't, but you don't need it. You don't need it. And sometimes it just takes you down another rabbit hole for a while, and it just causes some more confusion, right? So just know that whatever you want's done, best version of it exists in this moment, and it's coming to you now. Like, it's literally, it's you are becoming a magnet to those experiences, best version, when you relax, when you enjoy this moment, when you make the best of where you're at. So it's really simple. You're making the best of where you're at with your life now, whatever's happening in your life now. And when you don't feel good, when you can't, when something shows up in your current reality that doesn't feel good, it's time for me to do the practice. It's time for me to get calm, quiet, and relax my body. And that's literally all you're ever doing. That's all you're ever doing. So I went down the rabbit hole, April, of trying to get into, like, understanding how this, it's simple. Like, we're all having our own personal experience, but this is only your energy, and everyone else is having their own personal experience, right? So you don't want to, like, think too much into that, because you got to make it just about you and how you feel, and that's it. Because if you start thinking about other people and, you know, how they play a part in your life, you're going to drive yourself crazy, and then it's like another trap, right? You only need to make it about you and how you feel in each moment. How can I make the best of this moment? Because you actually serve others by doing that. So by you feeling the best you can in this moment, making the best of this moment, whatever that may mean, you can't make a mistake. There's no wrong choice. And when I can't, I get calm and quiet. I just relax and let that moment pass. And it passes. That's always a limitation. That's always a belief system that doesn't serve you. It passes. Don't try to figure it out, guys. Get out of that habit as well. Because like I said, you're either flowing in this moment or you're resisting. You're fighting with this moment. You're either fighting with this moment or you're flowing with it. You want to flow with this moment at all times. And that's your practice. Your practice is to continuously get into the habit of flowing with this moment, being in flow, right? Not resisting it, right? Not fighting with it, fighting against it, right? And the more you do the practices, you will. Meditation, I tell people that are new to this to start a meditation practice. That's where I started out meditating. You can see why I get exhausted with lives. It's so exhausting. And I scream. Start out with a meditation and breath work practice. That's the first two things that I did. And again, I talk about this in my ebooks. Guys, by the way, if you're new, get my ebooks because they're half off up until October 24th. So get them. When a thought comes and I don't feel good and then relax but don't feel good. Now, if your body's relaxed, Val, even though you have a thought that doesn't serve you in that moment, that doesn't feel good in that moment, or something's even bothering you, if you're relaxing your body, Val, that's enough. That's enough, Val. Listen, it'll pass. And you will feel better. You know that. You know that you'll feel better. And just know this. By you relaxing your body and allowing that to pass even through the discomfort veil, you are bringing in more positive, better experiences. Like, it's automatic, guys. It's automatic, okay? You just got to keep doing it for a little bit to start really noticing it. Do we just become unbothered by unwanted? Well, no, because the more you do these practices, yeah, you will. It'll be like one more time something might come in mindful to, like, because the reason why things show up that don't really serve you is because you're still somewhat reactive to them. But the more you do these practices, they get lighter and lighter. So it may show up one more time, but it's not about living a life of being unbothered, guys. It's not, because your life gets better. You're doing things that are more in alignment with you. Your experiences are positive. You don't have to keep... You're not living a life of just walking around like, I have to be unbothered. But at first you are, because that's what stops you from reacting to these things that keep showing up in your reality. So you keep getting calm and doing the practices. They get lighter and lighter. They start to fade away. So like one more time they may show up, but you really can see, you'll know. It'll be like, oh wow, that's not affecting me at all, right? So like I always say, like life still happens around you. Like you'll still see certain things. But yes, you do. They don't affect you like they used to anymore. You're too happy for things to affect you anymore, mindful. You just get to that place, you're over the hump where you're just happy. If somebody says something to you and they're like, you're crazy, you won't even care, because you're just like in your own happy bubble. You're like, sorry that you're not happy, but I am, right? You know what I mean? Oh, Vail, I missed that. Could you put that back up? Because it's the belief is very dominant, Vail. When it's a dominant belief that you've had for a very long time, Vail, it's dominant. That's all it is. It's when you don't feel good, Vail, and you're still relaxing your body, it's a dominant belief system. But don't worry about it. Don't try to figure it out, Vail. Guys, it's normal for it not to feel good. We have some dominant beliefs that we've had over time. Like, we pick these things up from our childhood, right? So they're in there. So, but trust me, you just keep relaxing, you keep softening, because you're doing the opposite of what that belief is. That belief is dense. That belief is hard, right? That belief is dominant. But by you softening your body, Val, guys, it is fading away. But yes, they don't feel good. I know. They cause a lot of discomfort. Trust me, I know. But you're doing the right thing by staying light, by staying soft. Flowing means accept the three. Yeah, exactly, April, exactly. Exactly. Listen, guys, what April said, read what she said, guys. It's exactly that. You are accepting where you're at in this moment. That's key to this. That's very powerful. Like, that's full power. Like, I'm accepting where I'm at in this moment, but I know I'm moving towards best and better. And that's it. And then you're just doing the practices. Felt pretty down because of my test score, even though I thought, oh, that's okay. It's okay. Just stay calm and relaxed. Don't ask why. Listen, that's the thing, guys. When something happens in your life, you got to make it a habit. When something like that happens, is to stay calm and quiet. And by you doing that, something better will come take its place. Always, okay? So don't be so hard on yourself. Don't make it a bigger deal, right, in that moment when you don't feel good. Like something like that. You just stay calm. You stay quiet. Something better will always take its place. That's the practice. When I don't feel good, when something shows up, a circumstance in my reality unfavorable, and it doesn't feel good, it's my job to get calm and quiet, relax my body so something better can take its place. That's it. And that's in regards to whatever you're manifesting and, you know, just your best life in general. This is how you move out of these limiting beliefs, okay? So it's just a practice you got to keep doing to start seeing. Like, don't take these things so seriously. I know it's easier said than done. I've been on the other side of it, guys. My whole life was shaken, so I get it. But you really have to understand, the more you do these practices, you're going to laugh. You're going to laugh, because none of that, they're all just realities that have been created over time. People's opinions, people's beliefs, and they become our reality. They become a part of who we are. And the more that you let them go, you look back and you think, I can't even believe I let those things upset me. You laugh at it later on, but at first it feels so real. It feels so real, but it's not. It's not. So you just got to just be consistent with the practices, okay, guys? I promise you, it's a lot. I know, Christine. I'm late tonight because I was saying I'm not sleeping. So these lives tire me out. So I was like, let's do a live. Why not? Yeah, Val, a lot of stuff comes up, Val. Don't worry about it. You're like, even that is, that's sometimes we're so hard on ourselves. It's like we react to the fact that, like, why we ask the question, like, why is this not working? Am I doing something wrong? But you're not. It's literally this simple. I'm not kidding, guys. You just got to keep doing it. Keep, trust me, it's so worth it. You're not really doing much. Do the other practices that I talk about too, Vail. Do the other practices, like really enjoying those moments, like when you're relaxed. Like I always say, like when you're drinking a cup of coffee or a cup of tea, or when you're laughing with friends, or when you're in a warm blanket, or in the sunshine, or in the bath, or in the shower, guys, warm water. Like really try to, like, those are very powerful moments. Like that's a state of appreciation, what Abraham talks about. You want to really embrace those moments when you're enjoying food. But listen, it takes practice. Non-reaction takes practice, but it's literally leading you to your freedom, to everything you want and more. Trust me. And listen to my, guys, listen to my audio. I know a lot of you's got it. Val, you have it, right? Listen to it in those moments. It's going to remind you, all I'm doing is relaxing. All I'm doing is softening. And I'm adding more to it. So you're going to get more soon, guys. If you have the audio, I'm going to be adding more. It's more. This one's really good. It's a lot about the present moment. Can you feel when something is about to manifest or usually? So April, my manifestations have been so gradual and like they just, it's like almost like you don't notice it. But yes, certain other things, April, to me, like that you might feel like are bigger. It's like, yeah, you kind of like certain things you might feel like they're coming, right? Like that little bit of excitement or whatever. But most of my manifestations are so natural. It's just a part of my life. It's just me coming more into alignment because I really try not to think about my manifestations. I made that my practice. And it's the most powerful practice. It's not easy because people are so programmed to think about their manifestations and thinking they have to do things. But you are in full power when you are in this moment now and not thinking about them. So for me, it's all about not thinking about them. That's what led me to best case scenario in my life, in a lot of areas in my life. Like I talk about my ebooks, guys. I talk about these audios. I did not do nothing. Listen, I am not tech savvy. I never thought that I could do the stuff that I am doing right now. The fact that I even do TikToks and do lives, guys, I never spoke in school. I was the shyest kid in school. I was the shyest kid my whole life. I'm not kidding. There was nobody shyer than me. So the fact that I'm doing this right now and it's so effortless for me and how it happened and evolved, I can't explain it to you guys. It's because I do these practices and that's it. That's what led me to this spot here. So it's hard to explain because it was my path of least resistance and it all evolved so effortlessly for me. It was so natural. Also, I'm in my own world. I don't compare myself to others. You want to get out of those things too, guys. You don't want to be scrolling through other people's TikToks, comparing yourself to other people. Don't be watching manifestation teachers and stuff like that because a lot of them make it way more difficult. If they're not saying you only have to practice non-reaction, they're making it more difficult because this is the easiest way to manifest. It's about being in this present. Anything else is taking you away from this present moment. All your power is in this present moment. So anybody teaching this should be telling you to get back into this present moment and that everything's done, right? Everything you want is done, best case scenario. Your only job is to get your attention and focus back to this present moment. If you're not teaching it any other way, it's limiting. It's limiting. It's a cycle. It's a program. Talk more about the path of least resistance, please. Well, this is the path of least resistance. Like what I'm explaining. Non-reaction, relaxing, meditating. That's deprogramming your mind and it's putting you on the path of least resistance. The path of least resistance, if you are really doing these practices and you're making it about relaxing and non-reaction, you're not going to even be aware of your manifestations unfolding. Your life just starts to get better. It's very gradual, it's very natural, it's very effortless. There's no action. Take the word action out of your manifesting vocabulary, because there's no action. I'm not kidding. It's just, your life is just happening. Okay, I'm going to go food shopping now. Okay, I'm going to go do a live right now. Oh, you know what? I want to make this funny TikTok. Okay, let me start down. I'm editing my book. Like, your life is just happening, right? That's the path of least resistance. And like I said, things are just happening. A lot of things you don't know, you can't see. You're not really supposed to. That's trust. It's helping you trust more. But it's different for everybody. Everyone has their own path of leap, but you won't realize it. You won't realize it because it's just, it's like Bob Proctor put it the best way. He said, you're going to look back and the steps don't make sense in while it's happening, but you'll look back and you're like, wow. Everything makes sense to me though. It's because I live in the present moment though. I'm always bringing my attention back to now. How to let go of what people think of you, especially when they gossip. Well, it's only you and your energy. Dot. Always remind yourself that. So that's just a limiting belief within you. So you have to stay calm and quiet around that topic. To think that anybody's talking about you, it's just a limitation, right? That doesn't feel good. So remember, anything that doesn't feel good is a limiting belief within you. So we stay calm, we stay quiet, we relax our body, and that's going to start to fade out of your life. And you're going to realize that nobody's gossiping, nobody's talking about you. I had the same things play in my mind, and it's not even that at all. The more you feel better on your own, the more you feel whole on your own, you only get positive reflections of people in your reality, right? So you can't make it about other people, though, Dot. You and guys, you got to make it just about you and you having your own experience and what can I do to feel good. You got to be able to feel good no matter what's happening around you at first, right? It's an internal shift that happens within. So you're using everything in your reality to practice feeling good, no matter what, people, places, and things. That's the practice. The practice is getting yourself to a place where I feel good no matter what's happening or outside of me. If somebody's gossiping, if there's a group of people gossiping, I'm just going to slowly walk away from that. Because if there's things on TikTok that don't feel good to me, I'm going to scroll right past them. I don't want that in my reality, right? There's a lot of things you can control. A lot of things you can. Some things, a lot of things we can at first. That's where we're accepting it, knowing we're moving towards better. But things like people gossiping and things that you don't really want to watch anymore on TV or your social media, you have a choice there to say no, right? To like not scroll. I'm going to grab a chair. Okay. How do you pinpoint where you go wrong with manifesting? You're not doing anything to manifest. That's the thing. You're too much. That is a you not being in the present moment. So that question right there would be, oh, I don't have to worry about that. I just got to get back to this moment now. You're not making a mistake. There's no mistakes. You're exactly where you're supposed to be in this moment, right? But you're worried about the future. You're in that question energy. So right off the bat, I would say, all right, time to get back to this present moment. I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be. Everything's unfolding perfectly. What can I do now to feel good? All right, I'm gonna have a sip of my drink and just scroll through funny TikToks right now. That's it. That's all you're doing to be in the present moment. It's not difficult. You don't have to do anything extravagant in this moment, guys. Just by you doing little things that feel good in this moment, you're a magnet to your manifestations. That's it. Literally, I'm not kidding. Oh, Val, you know, you can't, 11:11 on my clock. You can't, guys, you cannot make a mistake. I'm going to make more videos of like explaining. You literally cannot make a mistake, I promise you. And you know what? Here's another thing that people get upset about. Oh, I just reacted. You didn't mess anything up. Because there only is this moment. It doesn't matter if you react it. I love when people tell me they react it and they were aware of it. Because now you're moving towards better and best in that moment just by being aware of it. You get calm and you relax your body now. But I keep overthinking when I hear anything negative being spoken. But that's the thing. You have to stay calm and quiet, Dot. You have to do these practices. That's where these practices, you have to start doing the practice, softening your body. Like, to the fact, that's a hard belief system. That's a dominant belief system. It doesn't feel good, right? That's a dominant belief system. That's hard. So you have to do the opposite in those moments, Dot. You have to soften your body. To relax your body, even though it might be playing out in your mind, right? That story, by you relaxing your body, softening your body, that hard, dense belief system that people are talking about me, people are gossiping about me, it's starting to fade out of your life, right? You are taking your power back in that moment by relaxing it, but you got to keep doing it, right? You got to say, oh, wait, I'm letting that bother me again. Let me soften. Let me relax. Let me calm myself down. You're soothing yourself. You're settling yourself. You're settling down in those moments, right? Calming yourself down. How does relaxing and releasing limiting beliefs? Wait. Hold on. How does relaxing and releasing limiting say the story doesn't matter with weight loss? It doesn't, because if that doesn't feel good, anything around your body, foods, even just like saying that, oh, I'm going to get so fat now that I'm eating this. That doesn't feel good. You stay calm around that. That's a limiting belief. Nothing here has meaning, guys. So the more you understand, like, food and all that doesn't have meaning, right? Well, you guys would hear what I do to work out. I do nothing. Like, you would laugh at my workouts. But you release those limitations in your life that tell you you have to do this. You have to eat salad. You have to work out 7 days a week and 3 hours at the gym. I do 7 minutes. That's my workout. It might even be six. Some days I miss a lot of days. Like, I'm the most fit I've ever been. You have to stay calm and quiet. There's just a limiting belief. If it doesn't feel good, it doesn't match what you want. Plain and simple. If it doesn't feel good, it doesn't match what you want. You just got to keep doing the practices. I was saying I didn't gain weight. You were saying you didn't gain weight, but that's the thing. That's persisting, Vixen. That's what I tell you not to do. I was saying I didn't gain weight. I don't gain weight. I don't gain weight. But guess what you're saying to yourself? I'm gaining weight. I'm gaining weight. I don't tell anyone to persist in a manifestation, so you're not getting that from me. I tell you not to say a darn thing. Stay calm. Stay quiet. Relax your body. That's how you're releasing a limiting belief, not by persisting. I don't gain weight. I didn't gain weight. I don't, not that, that's not me. I would never tell anyone to do that. That's you focused on a manifestation. You're too focused on what you don't want. That's all that is. You want to keep, Dot, definitely. Yeah, they're the best moderators ever. Yeah, guys, I don't break a sweat. Christine will tell you. I don't break a sweat. I never really ever really did break it. Guys, I'm all about lazy. I don't call myself a lazy manifester for nothing. Listen, you're unlimited. This can be as easy or as hard as you want it to be. It's your choice. I just give you the teachings to help you guys make this easy. I like it things easy. I know that this can be easy if you want it to be. I just kept doing the practices over and over again until I mastered them. So you'll master non-reaction, but you got to be consistent. What was your manifestation journey? What was my manifestation journey? Well, I mean, I guess it started with not being happy just like everybody else, right? I had tons of limiting beliefs and I was working jobs and, you know, barely getting by type. And, you know, that's where I was. But for me, it all started, it was definitely Abraham Hicks. Listening to Abraham Hicks. Oh, you were saying you didn't gain weight. I don't understand what you mean. You're saying, I said I didn't gain weight, but I put on 20 pounds. My SP told me he prefers someone else over me. And she. So that easy answer to that. I'm focusing on me. You need to be whole. You're not whole yet. You need to feel good on your own. You need to be healthy on your own. You're needing someone outside of you to feel better. You want to get out of that. You're not, and if you're doing anything to manifest, you're chasing something. So You need to be self-empowered. You need to feel good on your own. You need to be happy on your own. You need to be healthy on your own. You need to be whole on your own. What if an authority wants to dispose of your dogs? That feels terrible to me. It's a limiting belief. Limiting belief. It's you having your own experience with your belief systems. That your belief systems are creating that story. So your limiting belief system right now, that fear-based belief system, is creating that story. So again, calm, quiet, relax your body. Let that fade. Yeah, I think I got it right, Sally, when I was answering her question. Like, you never want to, that's persisting, and that's what I tell people not to do. You're never persisting in a manifestation. You're never telling a new story. That's very limiting, and it's keeping you in opposition of it. You're bringing up more limitations. You're creating more limiting beliefs just by doing that. That's a limiting belief. To think that you have to change a story and persist in it, yeah, it can work, but it's very temporary. Listen, that's surface level manifesting. This is what I say. Affirmations, visualization techniques, that's surface level. You got to go below that. You got to make it about feeling. Got to make it about feeling, but you got to practice at it. You got to practice at it. Oh, Nathan, come on now. That looks pretty darn good to me. Maybe it's a hair. Can my actions mess up? No, because you can't make a mistake. You can't make a mistake, Apple. Can't make a mistake. But just keep bringing your attention back to this moment now, with the life you're living now, with just yourself being feeling good on your own, right? Here the whole time. Getting out of a situation. So you can. No, there's not, April. Like, it's not, you're allowed, if you can remove yourself from something, yes, but just do the practices, that's all. There's no wrong or right, April. If you decide to remove yourself from a situation, yeah, that's fine. There's no wrong or right. Just be consistent with these practices, that's all. Because a lot of times, you'll leave a situation, but that situation's still on your mind, right? And it's still bothering you, you're not practicing the practice. So you're just going to attract other situations like that based off that belief system that created that in the first place. So you just got to be consistent with the practices. That's all. Now, just feeling the best I can in this moment, Faith. I just know it's my job to feel good and that's it. So for me, I'm just living my life in this moment. There's no default. It's just, I know how this works. I've done this long enough, right? So it's just, I just live in this moment, doing the best I can in this moment, feeling the best, like making the best of this moment. And if something ever shows up that sets me off even just a tad, I just know to get calm and not take it personal, relax my body, and then it fades. And I move, but I'm good. I've been doing this for a while, so I've mastered it. But you're mastering non-reaction. That's you being in alignment. That's your only practice. You feeling good no matter what's happening around you. You making the best of each situation you're in now. That's it. So you just get better at it. But there's no default emotion, right? You can experience all your emotions. You can cry. You can laugh. You can be so excited. You can be happy. But you always want to be able to get yourself centered again. Because you don't want to get dependent on things outside of you to feel a certain way or get lost in emotions either, right? And start getting sucked into those types. But the more you do this, you don't. You just don't anymore. You're on the other side of things. You get it. You know how this reality works. You really start to enjoy this experience and you get it. What can I do right now? So I manifest them to stop talking. Now, you are, Apple, you are way too focused on a manifestation. You gotta meditate and do breath work. You gotta start out there. Is focusing on, yes. In the most part, you're in opposition. And not only that, JC, you're limiting yourself. So when you're focused on a manifestation and you're like trying to like create the story and that kind of, you're limiting yourself. You can bring it in that way. I've done it. It's just very limiting. You find yourself back to square one. You're not happy again. Your best case scenario is when you're not focused on your manifestation. That's how you bring things in the best way possible, is when you're not focused on it at all. Literally, I'm not kidding. It's about you making the best of your life now and just doing what you can do now to feel good. It evolves very naturally and effortlessly, and best case scenario in each moment. And each moment, your life just keeps getting better. I ask about the emotion because people make it seem like you have to. No, not at all, Faith. It's not even gratitude, because gratitude, like Abraham always talks about this, and she's right. Gratitude, there's lack in gratitude. There's lack in gratitude. Oh, I'm so grateful. And I know what she means now, because now that I've been doing this for a while, it's almost like that's not worthiness. Gratitude is not. You're like, oh, I'm so thankful for this. Almost like you don't deserve it. You want to be more in those states of appreciation. And that's when you're just in a warm blanket. That's when you're sitting in the sunshine. That's when you're getting a warm shower or soaking in the bathtub. Like, that's appreciation, guys. Like, it's not what you think. Gratitude, there's lack in gratitude, actually. How to center yourself, any top. Yeah, yes, actually, Dot. I have three that changed my life, Dot, more recently, that I talk about a lot. It's throughout your day, Dot, is to relax your face. Because a lot of times we hold a lot of tension in our face, our teeth. So relax your face, drop your shoulders, and take a breath out. Do that all day long. If you can set a timer on your phone and do it all throughout the day, every day, you're going to find yourself more relaxed just in your everyday life. And you will see changes in your reality just by doing that practice. So that would be a practice that I would recommend to you guys, is that one. And I'm going to add this, being in a state of appreciation more. Really being aware of those moments when you are comfortable, when you're in a blanket, before you go to sleep, before you wake up and you're nice and warm, like stuff like that. So I focus on myself, but can I still once in a while visualize? You can do whatever you want. I'm not going to tell you what you can and can't do. I just say not to, because for the most part, you're in opposition and you're not feeling good when you're visualizing it, because you're not there yet. You're still reactive towards that story. So I say no. I would tell you no, but you can do whatever you want. That's just me. Me personally, I wouldn't. I wouldn't visualize it. I would put myself right back in this moment. What can I do to feel good? You got to feel good on your own. You got to practice feeling good on your own. You got to not care what people are doing outside of you, how they're behaving outside of you. You got to learn how to be, I don't care. I'm fine. I'm still happy. I can still feel good. If people are talking about something you don't like, I can still feel good. I can block that out. I can walk away. Like, that doesn't affect me, right? You got to get to that point. That's when you start getting better, more positive reflections from other people. My old life doesn't suit me. Just know in this moment always that you're now moving towards best and better. You're moving towards best and better. Don't try to figure it out. Remember, you can be specific, but it's okay not to be specific. So just the fact that you know this information now, I'm unlimited. I can be, do, and have whatever I want. I'm here to live an amazing life is enough. It's enough. You don't have to. You'll get clear. You're not here to prove anything, guys. You're not here to there's not this big, huge purpose that you're here to fill. You're here, your purpose is to be happy. That's your purpose. You're here to live an amazing life. That's your purpose. So how I started, Dot, I don't read any books. I would say my ebooks, my three ebooks. I don't read any books. I've never read a book on any of this. Never read a book on self-help, never read a book on manifesting, never read a book on anything at all. I do not like to read, which is hilarious because I write. I'm a writer, but I don't like to read. So I would say my ebooks. So meditation for me, I don't meditate anymore because I know how to meditate like on the spot. But I started out by listening to air conditioned noise or a fan noise. And I kept redirecting my focus to that noise over and over and over again. At first, yes, it was exhausting, but it does get easier. And it gets to be actually enjoyable because you know that you're connecting to the infinite field of possibilities when you meditate, when you quiet your mind. That's why relaxing practices are so powerful, guys. You're connecting to the infinite realm of possibilities. So that's why I recommend meditation. But meditation's easy. Set a timer for 20 minutes before you start your day and just listen to like a fan sound, air conditioned sound, something like that that you like, a cool beat or something. Sometimes images can help, like a spinny image that like catches your attention, right? I have it on here too. It's called Easy Fun Meditations. I have a playlist. Thanks, Ryan. Nay, it makes me sleepy too. So as I was, guys, like I tell you guys, I love to write, right? But when it comes to editing my ebooks, I'm like falling asleep. It's actually can help you fall. If you don't like to read, you can use it to your advantage. It's meditative. It can kind of help you fall asleep. But every time I'm done writing an ebook, I'm like, all right, I got to take a break from these. I love the audios. I live for the audios. To me, the audios will change your life. So will the ebooks because it's all my information in there. Audiobooks, it's just in the audiobook form, but I believe that that's the answer. The answer, because you need to remind yourself in those moments that you're okay, you're safe, you're making progress, you can't make a mistake, and that's what the audios are for. Oh, I love that. Linda, so you fall asleep with me in your mind talking. Oh, yeah, that's a good one too. So Nathan said white noise. There's like white noise, there's gray noise, right? There's like all kinds. Yeah, so that's another good one. I know your TikTok. Yeah, and April, guys, go to my YouTube. I just posted the most recent one. Not the most recent. Yeah, I posted the most recent one. Go to YouTube. All my lives are on there. Listen to them. Listen to them. If you don't have the audio, listen to the lives. They're just as good. Especially more recently, my lives have been really, really good because I'm not doing them as much. So they're on point with this information. So listen to them. Yeah, right? Nathan, it like blocks out all sounds, right? Like even for me, sometimes that's why I like some type of something like a noise. It's just very soothing. It's very soothing. That, no, you are not, Christine. That, now, nothing beats that. Nothing beats that. I want that forever. Listening to the ocean to go to sleep. Yeah, that's all it is. Yes, Angel. So whenever I would have, I would start doubting, I would just relax and I'd always hear, like, you're exactly where you're supposed to be. You are. You're exactly where you're supposed to be. You're just, and you are falling more into trust. The more you make it, listen, you want to be in this present moment, guys. That's the practice. That's what's going to help you do. It gets, you're going to be living in the present moment. There's not going to be no more. It's asking, it is given. Manifestations are just going to start to happen. You're not even going to be in that energy anymore of worrying and doubting and fear anymore. You're just in the moment and you're living your best. I can't tell you, my life, that's why another reason why I don't do lives as much is because I've been so invested, like, and involved in my reality, like with my kids and my family. And like, that's where I've been. My focus has been. So you're so present and in this moment. Like, I even think about just listening to my kids when they're talking to me. It's like, I'm just so focused, just sitting there listening to them talk to me. Like, it's just, your life just changes for the best in so many ways. You're not in your headspace anymore. And even if you do go there and it's not, it doesn't feel good, you're thinking about something, it's so easy for you to get back into this moment and you go, no, I don't got to do that anymore. It's easy just to settle yourself down and get yourself back to this present moment. So it's everything. But I'm telling you, it takes practice. It takes practice. No, you haven't missed any. Nathan, I'm not doing them as much, but I'll break it up for you. Like, I'll do like some during the day, some at night, but you haven't been missing anything. I haven't really been on live as much because I get so tired from lives, right? Because like I answer a lot of the same questions and it's like, sometimes it's very repetitive for me. So I've been like kind of taking a break from them because they've been exhausting me, but I will, Nathan, I will definitely mix up the times a little more. Ah, oh, Iceman, yes. It is, and guys, it's not a secret. We all know, Eckhart Tolle could tell you, right? It's all about the present moment. It's all about the present moment, right? I always think about, like, it's just now you know in this moment that you're unlimited and that everything you want is done. That's the only difference. But your power is in the present moment. Full power. Full power is in this present moment. And we just got to practice getting into this present moment. Yeah, exactly, Christine. And then I said, guys, listen, I mean this. And when I say these things, and then I'll hear like Bashar say the same thing that I said. This is accurate. Like they explain it differently than me, but it all means the same thing. When you're calm and quiet and you relax your body and you're keeping those moments that don't feel good to yourself, it's automatically being replaced with a positive one, something better. I'm telling you, that's all you're ever doing. That's why you're always making progress when you do this practice. And you can't make a mistake. Why? You just get better at this. That's all. There is no mistakes. You just got to keep practicing this. This is all you're doing. This is it. Is there a meaning behind high vibration and experience? I don't get into that talk too much, Madeline. The byproduct of doing these practices is that you feel better most of the time. So that would be called high vibration, but I don't use those words and labels because they've got completely blown out of proportion in the manifesting world. High vibration, people think high vibe is like, you know, you don't gotta be high vibe. Well, that's the byproduct of non-reaction, is that you are in higher energies. Because once you release fear-based belief systems, that's high vibration, right? You're getting into those higher frequencies. So it's automatic. It's just automatic. But I don't really use those because they've gotten used and abused. So I always just say, listen, the byproduct of non-reaction, you start to feel good because you're living the life you came here to live. You can't be anything but that in alignment. It's just the byproduct of it. That's all. So you live in your best life. Hey, Marie. Hey, Divine. I know, right? They are. These methods are amazing. They really are. And that's why I say, like, it cracks me up because, like, people will say, like, oh, I didn't know you had a book. I never direct people to my books because they are not... My ebooks are where it's at. My most recent ebooks, Feel Good to Stay Calm, Release Resistance, and now How to Stay in Flow, which will be out soon. And the audio. That's your package right there for non-reaction. That's everything. That's everything you need to know that I talk about. It's everything. So I don't tell people, you can get my ebooks, like I have free ones. They're great resources, but the most recent is where it's at. That's where I really got a grasp on this myself. So that's where it all started for me. The other things they're great. They're little resources, and that they were while I was on this journey to like really trying to understand this myself, right? So we never come back to feeling bad. Old days, it's forever. Yeah, Vale. Here's the yes. Oh, Vale. Yes, girl. Let me tell you, you're so on top of your thoughts, Vale. There's no more of that. You're out of that. You're out of those. You get rid of all your fear-based belief systems, Vale. I'm not kidding. You don't have those experiences anymore in your life. And Vale, if something slightly set you off, you're so quick to get back in alignment, Vale. Not at all. But at first, Vale, guys, listen. If you're having a day where you're down in the dumps, it's a good thing. please understand, this is a lot of my new ebook's going to talk about this, guys. Not feeling good is good. Not feeling good is good. It's literally everything, because it's on the other side of that is everything. So really just understand that it's a good thing. Just stay calm and quiet. Let it take as long as it needs to pass. Listen, sometimes it would take a day. I know it sucks. I have kids. Like, I was trying to live my life. Like, I'm like, dude, like, let's go. Let's get on with these fear-based belief systems. I got to live my life, right? But they do. It gets better. I promise you. I promise you it gets better. Yeah. Yeah. See, like, people used to say, like, you can't. I used to hear that a lot in the manifesting world when I first got into this. Oh, you can't feel good all the time, and you can still manifest when you don't feel good. And I'm like, that felt so limiting to me. You're supposed to feel good. We're supposed to, that's our true nature, guys. Like, your true nature is light. Your true nature is soft. Your true nature is carefree, fun. That's your truth. Anything but that is a limiting belief. It's a limitation. Life is like surfing, ride the wave. Yes, Pixie, right? I know. So that was my first ebook on emotions. That's the one where I would talk a lot about emotional roller coaster. It's a good ebook. They're all good ebooks. But like I said, my most recent ones are where you're going to get your best resources for non-reaction, your best resources for living in the present moment. Yeah, and it's how you face them, right, Nathan? It's about staying calm in those moments and knowing that everything serves a purpose. Like, it's how you see things in that moment. But I can tell you, I've had a lot of difficult circumstances. I don't have them anymore, and I don't feel like I'm ever gonna have to really experience those again. I really feel like I'm out of that. I'm gonna be honest with you. My life is very smooth sailing right now. Like, I don't have big things that I had to work through some things to get through that, but I'm past that. What is this called? What is what called? What is what called? The live? You will, Dot. You will. You will. The more you do these practices, you will, Dot. The more you feel good on your own and you do... you know, you're doing things for yourself, getting in those states of appreciation more, you will start to become whole. That's what these practices do, Dot. You become whole. You become whole on your own, right? And again, that's what's, again, making you magnetic. So just keep doing the practices and you'll know what I mean. Yeah, I got it today, but it's, look at it. It's, I got it earlier. So it's kind of like, it's a little watered down, but. I was going to have a cup of tea, but if I drink a cup of tea too late, I'll be going pee a lot. Not that I won't probably pee from this, but. Exactly, Nene. Exactly. Just don't try to figure too much out. Let life surprise you. It takes practice to get to the point where it's like, I can just chill, sit back. And when you're enjoying this moment now, you don't feel the need to try to figure things out anymore. You're just in this moment. But you got to break through some belief systems first before you can enjoy this moment, right? Like I had to. But that's where you're going to just do the calmness practices, quiet, calm. Oh, Katie, I love that. Keep going, Katie. It's only the beginning, guys. It's only the beginning. I used to say... So I was talking about this for a while, making TikToks about this for a while, and then I would have a bad day, and I would, you know what, one bad day feels like your whole world's falling apart. It feels like you made no progress, but it's not. It's part of the process, right? So I would be great, and things would be good, and I'm getting all this wisdom and information, and I'm sharing it with you guys, and then I'd have a bad day, and I'd be like, I'm a liar. This doesn't work. This is bullcrap. I'm trying to help all these people, but I don't feel good. It's part of it. You have to understand that it's part of it. You don't always feel that way. You don't. You just got to know it's part of the process. It's literally part of the process. And that's my biggest message. And that's why I create the things I create for you guys. And I always talk about this so much and remind you guys, because you do think when you're having a bad moment that this doesn't work. It's like everything bad is you're seeing in that moment. Mm-hmm. Right, Divine? That's okay, John. I have plenty of lazy days. I talk about this too. I was saying, you know, I have days, guys, where I'm busy. And I don't like the word productive. I don't use that anymore. But I have days where I'm like, I'm just on the go. And then I have days where I'm just in the house, just cooking and cleaning, and I'm not really doing anything. I'm like scrolling through TikTok. But it's all good because I make the rules. I create my own reality. And guess what? I like it that way. I like that my days are always different. I like that I live in the present moment. I don't know if, you know, am I going to make dinner today or am I not going to make dinner today, you know? That's all right, Sybil. That's okay. Just calm yourself down in those moments, Sybil. It's you, you know, it's again, it's like you're not in that present moment again. Just deal with things. That's the practice, guys, is like when you're in your mind too much. It's split energy. It's you're everywhere. You got to get back to this present moment. It'll all work itself out, Sybil. The more you practice being in this moment and saying, you know what, it is what it is, it'll all work itself out. You'll see that it'll all work itself out, right? It's like we start taking things too serious again. And we start saying, I got all this to do. I'm never going to get it done. And if you got to stop that. Dead in its tracks. You got to say, no. We don't do that anymore. There's nothing serious going on here. And bring yourself back to this present moment. Use it to your advantage. Take that breath. Listen, this is what I say. Whatever doesn't get done at the end of the day, it wasn't that important. And guess what? I don't even think about it ever again. Everything will work itself out. And you'll start to see that more. You'll literally be in control of your life. You're letting go of control to be in control. You really are in control when you're letting go of control, right? All this is very, it's very like contradicting all these practices. It's like you really are letting go. But like I said, the more you let go of control, you actually gain control. Yes, that's exactly what's going to happen, LB. You do start to build your trust. You do. I'm telling you guys, I used to think, what the heck? I had no idea where my life was going. I had to trust, because I would have been poor on the streets, homeless, honestly, if I didn't trust. I'm telling you, you do. You do just have to keep bring yourself back to this present moment and doing the practices. It's all going to work itself out. I am your example. I promise you. Listen, universal forces. They are begging you to relax and to take a step back and chill out. You gotta listen, guys. Like, well, you don't have to manage it all, Sybil. That's the thing. You don't have to manage it all. You have to remind yourself that all I have to do is get calm and relax when those stories start popping up in my head. That I gotta do all this. You create it. In your mind, you create that chaos in your mind and in your body by, I got to do all this, I got to do all that, I got this, that. It's all limiting beliefs. That's where you do these practices. That's where you use this to your advantage, to get calm, to get quiet, to relax your body. Trust me, I know. Having kids, I get it, but it does, it gets better, but you have to do the practices. You're not going to see the changes outside of you. You got to have the changes inside of you first. It's internal for you to start really seeing those things reflect back to you. You ignore your debt. You're not going to create more debt. Someone said something about debt. You're not going to create more debt, obviously, but you don't have to worry about your debt. That will work itself out, but you got to get out of, you're not manifesting money. You're not manifesting to pay off your debt, guys. You're manifesting financial freedom. So you can't, believe it or not, you really can't make it about money. You got to make it about energy flow. So you can work. That's what's breaking down your money, your fear-based belief systems around money, your limiting beliefs around money. Listen, all you have to do, these practices, non-reaction, it's you, you're going to start to feel better, which brings in things that get rid of, you'll get rid of your debt in a day doing these practices. Don't worry about the debt. You got to make the best of where you're at now with your money situation. That's how you get more money. That's how I did. It's by you making the best of where you're at with what you have. You got to make it work and you got to make the best of it, right? And then more will come in. More will come in. It's not going to come in these big lump sums. It just, you're getting more comfortable with money, right? But a lot of us have limiting beliefs around money, right? We're conditioned that way. I did. But you got it. You got to like get more comfortable with it coming in and knowing you can spend it. Like it goes out, it comes in, it goes out, it comes in, right? We always hear money doesn't even exist. It's just energy. Yeah. Well, we have to practice this for a lot of us, right? And you can't get dependent on it. So another thing with money is that when we see more money coming in, we get excited and we're like, oh my God, I can't believe it. I'm free. And then we watch it drop a little and we're like, oh no. So you got to watch how you're reacting around money, right? You got to watch how if you're making it conditional again, you're going back to those old patterns. Just know it's always going to keep coming in. You're always going to be taken care of, but you got to get comfortable with it, right? So make the best of where you're at. Make the best of where you're at and just know it's going to start coming in the best way, your path of least resistance. But it's all about energy flow, guys. That's why I talk about how to stay in flow. This takes care of everything. I wouldn't look at it like that, Marie. I would be like, oh, that's great. So it's how you perceive it in that moment. So you just put a negative meaning on it. Put a positive meaning, right? Oh, wow, it's a penny. That's so awesome. And just move on. Or if you can't put a positive meaning on it, put no meaning on it. Don't just stay calm, right? Right? No big deal. Just move on from it. But remember, you're not manifesting these money. Don't be so fixated on these things. Like I'm a millionaire. Don't be doing affirmations. You got to make it about this moment. Everything that I talk about is you getting yourself back into this moment and making the best of this moment. This will take care of everything for you, guys. Everything. When you're making the best of this moment now, you're taking care of it all. You're moving towards best in every area of your life, guys. But you got to make it about this moment now and feeling good now with where you're at. That's the trick. That's the secret, right? And when I can, I get calm, I get quiet, and I relax my body. That's a limiting belief. That's your Brianna, you're having your own personal experience with your belief systems. Me, Kira, I'm having my own personal experience with my belief systems. If I'm noticing people talking about me or this or that, that doesn't feel good, that's my belief system. I got to stay calm and quiet to release that. It has nothing to do with the people that. You can only experience that because of your belief, okay? So it's a little bit of an understanding. So you have to use it to your advantage, and you have to go, all right, time for me to do the practice. It's like calm, quiet, not speak about it, and relax my body so that belief system, that experience can fade from my life and be replaced with more positive ones, okay? All right, well, if you keep talking about it, you're going to keep experiencing it. So there you go. I just told you what to do, but you're saying you're still quiet. Don't speak about it. Calm and relax your body. It's a dominant belief system right now, and you're just keeping it active by speaking about it. So you can't speak about it. But we need the reminder. We all do. So, and it helps other people too. So you're not, it's just you need to remind yourself that I can't speak about it. I can't. I gotta calm. I know. It doesn't feel good. We let it take over. Relaxing your body's enough. Relaxing your body's enough. Oh, I answered her and she got it. She got it. Yeah, if that's relaxing for you, Faith, I mean, a lot of times visualizations happen before bed, right? Like, for me, visualization is so natural. I can't even explain it to people because I don't do it. It just happens. Like, you just find yourself relaxing, and before you know it, you're visualizing, right? It's just, you have these images. Does that mean my mindset is small? No. No, Marie, you create your own reality, girl. You know that. Not at all. Not at all. Money's money. Who says a penny's nothing? Who even makes that up, right? It's all belief systems. No. Seeing anything is good. I don't ever see money. I don't ever see it, like, laying around or anything, right? That's just a story you're creating, right? So just don't overthink it. Don't overthink it. When you find yourself going down that road and you're, like, in your headspace too much about something, calm, quiet. Calm, quiet. Just a limiting belief. Just a limiting belief. Let it fade. Nope. It's just like when people tell me they had a bad dream about this or that. I'm like, it's a dream. Just a dream. Calm yourself down. Relax. Move on from it. Are you used to always worry about money all day? Actually, it starts to become fun when money starts to come in and you're like, I always felt impulses to start spending it. Like, buy this, go do this, start doing this more, right? To get more comfortable with the in and out of money, right? The flow of money. So the more you do these practices, you get more comfortable. It starts to become fun. You're not worried about, I never actually worried about money, believe it or not. But I had limiting beliefs around it too, right? But I was starting my life by myself, like, all over again. So, like, I had to build my own belief systems, right? So it's more about, like, getting comfortable with that flow, right? I didn't see it. No. Strawberry refresher. Yeah. Look at it. It has it's all water right now. It's water with a splash of strawberry right now. Now, nobody can take your energy. Nobody can affect your energy. It's only you having your own experience. If you believe people can affect your energy, then people are going to affect your energy. That's a belief. Everything's a belief. Everything is a belief. Everyone, it's just a belief. So if you believe that people can affect you, if you believe people are jealous of you, you're just going to have experiences that show you that's true. Now, not at all, Fred. Actually, the complete opposite. You're going to say that I'm exactly where I am in this moment, and I know I'm moving towards more money in this moment and better in this moment. That's it. You can say you're a millionaire, but how does that feel for you? You just know you're unlimited now. You know you can be doing have anything you want. You know you're moving towards better. You know you're moving towards best. That's enough. You have to accept where you're at in this moment before you can move towards more and better in the right way. And I'm talking about financial freedom. Not just $1 million. Talk about financial freedom where money, it's not even a problem for you. When you feel like nothing's going right, meditation, relax your body, soften your body. Just stay calm, lay low. A lot of times we just got to I always say get through it, right? You just make the best of it. Because sometimes we still got to live, right? We still got to do things. Like, I still had to do things in those moments. I had kids. I still had to take care of myself and my kids. So I would stay quiet in those moments, Jack. Stay calm and get through it. And then I'd feel better. I would. You just start to feel better more and more and more and more the more you do it. Why not? I think you set up a little bit of a plan before we get here. Well, you are God. Like, we're all God is within all of us. It's not like, there's just not like this one God saying, this is how you're going to live your life. No, we're all connected. It's all the same energy. It's all the same thing. You're just having your own personal experience, right? I think the plan we have is to literally come here and break through these fear-based belief systems so we can live an amazing life. So we can experience, just have a fun, amazing experience. Because that's what this is supposed to be. It's not supposed to be like suffering, right? Which most people are stuck on the other side of it. But yeah, it takes practice. I don't sit and say it's easy. It took me practice to get here, but that's why I'm here, you know, with you guys, helping you guys, right? And giving the advice. Hey, Tess! Yeah, like, the Lulu is the Salulu. Yeah, so, like, my biggest thing with, like, being delusional is, like, well, you may seem like you're delusional to other people, but you don't feel it when you're in alignment. You feel normal. Like, this is me just living my life. I don't feel, but like other people might think I'm weird, right? Like doing my TikToks and people that have known me my whole life and be like, oh my God, they have, like, oh, like even my kids, not for nothing. My kids, like they're like I don't want to, don't put me in that TikTok. Like they want nothing to do with it, right? So like other people might think I'm delusional, but I don't feel delusional. I feel normal. I'm happy. I'm just living my life. I'm just living, guys. But like to someone else, they might think I'm delusional, right? So I don't really believe in delusional because you don't feel that way when you're just being yourself. Yeah, I think we come back, Faith. Yes. We've been everything. We've been everything. Like you've experienced many realities, right? You've experienced many lifetimes. Yes, I do believe that. Yes, without a doubt, without a doubt. How to correctly live in the end and affirm it? By knowing it's done, that's your end. Your end is it's done. You're not living in the end though. You're living in the now. That's how you bring it in the best way possible, Nessa, is by doing nothing at all to manifest. Nothing at all. Your end is that it's done, but you're living in the now. You're living in this moment with your life now, making the best of where you're at now, feeling good on your own now. When you don't stay calm, stay quiet, release that limitation. But you're not living, you're not doing anything to matter. That is a cycle you want to get out of. You don't want to be in that cycle. That's another limiting way to manifest. But again, I mean, you can do whatever you want, but I don't teach it that way. So don't react to 3D is the only, that's it. That's it, user. That's it. Literally, that's it. You just get better at not reacting by practicing non-reaction. If I shouldn't do affirmations, then whenever I think about it, should I embody it? No. Fred, no, not even that. Nope. I'm being serious, Fred. You may start to embody things, but not you won't realize it, Fred. So, like, it's weird because, like, the more you make it about this moment, things evolve so naturally and so effortlessly, guys. Like, I'm telling you, it's like, it just becomes your normal life. And I'm telling you, you're going to be like, what the heck? Who have I become? You're going to be amazed because I think about me, like, working and what I used to do and running around and, you know, like, that's not my life today. Like, it happens naturally. You're not embodying anything. I never embodied anything. I never pretended. I never acted as if. I never did any of that. When I did do that, it was very temporary and I was in a cycle and it was like, I found myself not happy again. It's really about feeling good with where you're at, guys. Yeah, and you know what, Sal? You don't have to be when you do it this way. That's what's so great about it, right? That there, you don't have to. You can still be logical, right? Like I said, it starts to become natural. So like, yeah, you start understanding how this reality works, but guess what? This is how this reality works. It's the truth. There's no delusional. There's no delulu here because it's facts. And how this reality works is that everything's reflecting back to you. This is just an experience. There's no delusion in that. It's just for some people that is delusional because they don't believe it, right? They're still in programs, right? Now, the only way excitement, the only way it's, if it's not, if, the only way it's reaction is if you're making it things conditional. So it's like you start to get dependent on it, right? So it's like money's coming in and you're loving your life, but then you notice the difference of it not being there. That's when excitement backfires because you're getting dependent on things. So no, excitement is not reaction. Happy's not reaction. It's when you notice the opposite again and you start making things conditional again. But the more you practice this, you'll understand that more, right? You'll understand that more. Excitement, no, you're going to experience all of your emotions, guys. When you're practicing non-reaction, you're going to get emotional. Like, I was watching a video today, I was crying my eyes out. But I was like a happy tears, right? You're not going to live like a robot. No, this is an experience. You're here to experience all your emotions. Doing these practices is not making you a robot. You're going to be more expressive. You're going to be so happy all the time. People are going to be like, whoa, like who? I haven't seen her or him in a while. They seem happy. I just seen someone yesterday and they were like, oh my God, you look great. Or because you're just so vibrant. You're just so happy. You're just so positive all the time. You're not a robot. You're just being yourself, guys. You're being yourself. But you know how to get back into alignment. It's just easy for you to just always feel good. Like you don't get triggered anymore. You're not sensitive like you used to be, to where like you take things so personal. You just brush things off, right? You just understand how this reality works now. You understand that you're having your personal experience with your belief systems and everyone else is having theirs with their belief systems. There's no need to ever take anything personally. No need. Because that's just their belief. So I don't get upset when someone says something that I don't agree with. I just don't agree with it. But I don't say nothing. I just don't agree with it. So I feel like standing for what's right makes my path harder. Yes. Without a doubt, Jack. That's a great point. Yes. Standing up for what's right is fighting against something. He's so right, Jack. That is such a good point. So I learned that too, Jack. Like, you don't fight against anything. Just bring it back to you and what feels good to you with your life. Because that's like almost like you're looking for things to fight against. I went down that path a little bit with manifesting and how other people were teaching this. And I stepped away and I don't listen to anybody. Because that's just them teaching it through their belief systems. And the more that you focus on it, you just keep it active in your reality. I don't want that in my reality. I want positive in my reality, and that's it. And I'm very aware of that and what I want to, how I want to live my life. So even with these lives, sometimes I have to stop and just make sure it's positive, right? Yeah, your thoughts will calm down, Fred. You will be, your thoughts won't be taking over you. You'll be in control of your thoughts the more you do these practices. Guys, I'm going to jump off though because I'm getting tired again, because that's what happens. I actually lose my voice. But I will be posting these on YouTube, so you'll catch them on YouTube. I have my most recent one up there. I'll put another one up there as well because I have one before that I want to post. You too, Nathan. Thanks, Nathan. And guys, have a great weekend. I have a party tomorrow, so I definitely won't be on tomorrow. But I don't know what days. I'll just kind of wing it. Like I said, I've been so busy, like at home and stuff. So when it's same thing, butterfly. Anything that doesn't feel good, you stay calm and quiet. That's it. Anything shows up in front of you, in your mind, it doesn't feel good. That's it, guys. It doesn't match what you want. That's all. So what do? Calm, quiet, relax my body, allow it to work itself out, fade out of your life. A better, more positive experience will take its place. It's automatic. This is an automatic process. You're only practicing non-reaction. That's it. All right, guys. Everybody have a great night and have a great weekend. Nice seeing you guys. Love you guys. Bye. Ugh, me awkwardly pressing the end button. I will, Faith. It's a little kids party, but I love these kids. They're my nieces and nephews. All right. Bye, guys.